Good afternoon everyone. Today my topic is cyberfeminism. So what is cyberfeminism? Cyberfeminism is a genre of contemporary feminism which foreground the relationship between the cyberspace, the internet and the technology. It can be used to refer to as a philosophy, methodology or community. According to dictionary meaning, a feminism movement concerned with the countering the perceived dominance of men in the use and development of information technology, the internet and etc. The term cyberfeminism was coined by Viennese Marxist and Australian artist collective active between the 1991 and 1997. Who, inspired by the Donna Haraway's Cyborg Manifesto, wrote the Cyberfeminism Manifesto for the 21st century. Cyberfeminism is considered a predecessor to networked feminism. Cyberfeminism also has relationship to the field of feminist science and technology studies. Cyborg Manifesto, written by Donna Haraway, is published in 1985 in the Socialist Review. The cyborg is a rejection of the rigid boundaries, notably those separating human from the animals and human from machine. The manifesto criticized the traditional notion of feminism, particularly feminism focuses on identity politics and encourages instead of qualities through the affinity. Haraway takes the issue with some traditional feminists reflected in the statement describing how women more than men somehow sustain daily life and so have a privileged epistemological position potentially. Here we find there are two types of cyberfeminism. First one is a liberal cyberfeminism and another one is radical cyberfeminism. So first, liberal cyberfeminism. The magazine Future Sex is one of the more extreme contributional to liberal cyberfeminism. It embraces the tenets of Haraway's cyborg feminism in order to advance sexual liberation theory, a political ideology which developed out of the feminist debates on sexuality in the 1980s and which continues to influence today's feminist politics. Proponents of the theory argue that the woman's sexual liberation is necessary before the gender politics can occur and oppose the claim of radical feminists that pornography is inherently harmful to women and should be made illegal. The unyielding antagonism between these two views is said to have divided American feminism into the misleadingly labeled camps of anti-pornography, radicalism and pro-sex liberalism, a split represented in the 1990s by anti-porn activist Catherine McKinnon and on one side and another pro-porn activist Susie Bright on another side. Catherine and Susie both are American feminists. Radical cyberfeminism. In response to this cyber masculinity, increasing the numbers of women have organized their own list and bulletin board system, creating women only space. Their participation can collaboratively construct an oppositional gender. One of the largest such space is Safe, a woman-only list dedicated primarily to the discussion of lesbian and bisexual issue. this electronic discussion group, according to a recent survey conducted by one of its subscribers, is made up of women associated with three major professional groups: university students and professors, women working in computer related fields, and women employed by universities in non-academic positions. Here I will try to apply cyberfeminism into very famous Me Too movement. In October 2017, hashtag Me Too movement forever changed the meaning of the word Me Too. An exposition of the stories about the sexual violence broke the internet. Over 1.7 million tweets, including the hashtag, reached over the 85 countries within the first 24 hours. Hashtag Me Too movement is best understood as a phenomenon enabled by the fourth wave of feminism. This new wave is especially associated with the social media, online activism, intersectionality, protesting against sexual harassment and rape culture. All of those components are intrinsic in the hashtag Me Too case. So this is my website. Thank you.